everybody. My name is Amber Campisi. I'm the community liaison with Beata Hospice. I'm here representing another wonderful community liaison, Alicia Bartlett, who works in our Bucks and Montgomery County. Thank you so much for joining Beata for this 4th of July celebration. We are going to be treated with some really special music by our amazing music therapist, Hannah Phillips. You will also hear a poem from one of our senior living home health program managers, Carrie Berger, as well as a special prayer from our chaplain, Samez Shaker. At the end of our program, there will be a 20-minute firework display. We will give you notice before this firework starts, just in case you want to lower the volume or you're just not interested in seeing them. No problem. We are just so happy that we got to be with you today and celebrate the 4th of July. We hope you enjoy the program.
Hi everyone, great to see you. If we haven't met before, my name is Hannah Phillips. I'm the music therapist with Beata Hospice, and we're going to be singing God Bless the USA, so please feel free to sing along with me.
If tomorrow things were gone, I'd work for all my life, and I had to start again with just my children and my wife. I thank my lucky stars to be living here today, 'cause the flag still stands for freedom, and you can't take that away. And I'm proud to be an American, or at least I know I'm free, and I won't forget those who died, who gave that right to me.
Titled My Country by Sarah Josepha Buell Hale. My Country. America, my own dear land, oh, tis a lovely land to me. I thank my God that I was born where man is free. Our land, it is a glorious land, and wide it spreads from sea to sea, and sister states in union join, and all are free. And equal laws we all obey, to kings we never bend the knee. We may not own no lord but God, where all are free. We've lofty hills and sunny vales, and streams that roll to either sea, And through this large and varied land, alike, we're free. You hear the sounds of healthful toil, and youth's gay shout and childhood's glee. And everyone in safety dwells, and all are free. We're brothers all from south to north. One bond will draw us to agree. We love this country of our birth. We love the free. We love the name of Washington. I lisped it on my father's knee. And we shall ne'er forget the name while we are free. My land, my own dear native land, thou art a lovely land to me. I bless my God that I was born where man is free.
Well, now we're going to do Ragged Old Flag by Johnny Cash. I walked through a county courthouse square. On a park bench, an old man was sitting there. I said, your old courthouse is kind of run down. He said, nah, it'll do for our little old town. I said, your old flagpole is leaned a bit, and that's a ragged old flag you got hanging on it. He said, have a seat, and I sat down. Is this the first time you've been to our little town? I said, I think it is. He said, I don't like to brag, but we're kind of proud of that ragged old flag. You see, we got a little hole in that flag there. Washington took it across the Delaware. And it got powder burned the night Francis Scott Key sat watching it writing, say, can you see? It got a rip in New Orleans with everyone tugging at its seams. And it almost fell at the Alamo beside the Texas flag. But she waved on through. She got cut with a sword at Chancellorsville. She got cut again at Shiloh Hill. There was Robert E. Lee and Beauregard and Bragg, and the south wind was blowing hard on that ragged old flag. On Flanders Field in World War I, she got a big hole from a Bertha gun. She turned blood red in World War II. She hung limp and low a time or two. She was in Korea, Vietnam. She went where she was sent by her Uncle Sam. She waved from our ships upon the briny foam, and now they about quit waving. Back here at home, in her own good land, here she's been abused. She's been burned, dishonored, denied, and refused. The government for which she stands has been scandalized throughout the land. She's getting threadbare and she's wearing thin, but she's in good shape for the shape she's in. Cause she's been through the fire before, and I believe she can take a whole lot more. So we raise her up every morning, and we bring her down slowly every night. We don't let her touch the ground. So on second thought, I do like to brag, because I'm mighty proud of that ragged old flag. And now, please join us for a prayer.
Hi everyone, my name is Samih Shaker. I'm a spiritual counselor with Bayada Hospice Ward Minister, and I will be sharing our prayer for 4th of July today. Let us pray. God, it is this day that we remember the coming together of many people for one cause. It is this day that we remember when from this unity was formed a nation. And it is this day that we give thanks for the blessings of freedom. It is this day that we remember the sacrifices of so many to bring forth the prospect of hope. It is this day that we remember the determination of so many to overcome adversity to give birth to a future. And it is this day that we ask such of ourselves that we would sacrifice today for prospect of hope tomorrow, that we would overcome adversity today at the possibility of a better future tomorrow. It is today that we pray to ask you to help us to unite as a diverse nation so that we can forge a better nation for tomorrow. It is today we remember our independence. It is today we give thanks for and honor that independence. Together as one, amen.
So we just want to take this moment to thank you so much for joining us today. Our team is really excited to find new ways to reach you. So through this live book Facebook stream, we are hoping that we're really just helping you get ready to celebrate your holiday weekend and just be proud and remember all the things that you love so much about celebrating our freedom and this country. We would love to hear from you. On the computer below, there is a place you can put a comment in, and our team during this hour is going to be joining us and being live as well, so they can just interact directly with you, and we'll all be jumping on too, just to let you know again how much we appreciate you. So feel free to write your comments below. You can let us know what your favorite 4th of July snack or food is, maybe you have a favorite type of firework, just anything. We're just so glad to be with you all to get ready for this holiday weekend. We also just want to give you a heads up, let you know that after this celebratory service, it will be followed up with a fireworks show, and there'll be a little bit of time if you want to turn your volume down or just take a pause, you'll certainly be able to do that. All right, thank you so much. So we also want to take just a little moment to do just a few little fun facts about this Independence Day. So the history of Independence Day, of course, is so much about festivities, including concerts, bonfires, parades, and the firing of cannons and muskets. Of course, that was a long time ago, but usually accompanied, all of that usually accompanied the first public readings of the Declaration of Independence, beginning immediately after its adoption. Of course, that was in what city? Philadelphia. The first fireworks were used not for 4th of July. But do you know how far back fireworks actually go? 200 BC. I think that's so interesting. So the first fireworks were used as early as 200 BC. And the tradition of setting off fireworks on the 4th of July began, as we said, in Philadelphia. On what date? July 4th? 1777. Also, the tradition of patriotic celebration became even more widespread after the War of 1812. And then later in 1870, the U.S. Congress made July 4th a federal holiday, which means they could grant paid holidays to all federal employees. Do you know what the most famous choice of food for holiday celebrations are? So many favorites, but barbecue. So many good barbecues. Also, of course, hot dogs. Can't have a barbecue without a hot dog. And then, out of the entire country, what state do you think holds the largest fireworks show? Is it Philadelphia? Is it out in California? Where do you think? New York. So New York is known for having the largest fireworks show. So just little bit of fun facts, and we hope that you are enjoying the service so far. We still have some more music for you coming up, and then, like we said, fireworks. Now we're going to close with a special song, Independence Day, written by Gretchen Peters and made famous by Martina McBride.
Well, she seemed all right by the dawn's early light, though she looked a little worried and weak. She tried to pretend it wouldn't happen again, but the tears were rolling down her cheek. I was only 8 years old that summer, and I always seemed to be in the way. So I took myself down to the fair in town on Independence Day. Small, small.
message from our social worker from our Beata Hospice office in Warminster, Joanne Moore.
Thank you everyone for coming and joining us today. We've been having so much fun for our wonderful celebration. And at the closing, we are going to be watching from the 2016 Washington Monument fireworks. It'll be about a minute after the closing. And again, on this special day, let us continue to move forward and make promise to take our nation on the path of prosperity so that people can have a happy life. Happy Independence Day to all. Thank you.